with your soul. Just tell him, ain't laying low. You was never really rooting for me anyway. When I'm back up at the top, I want to hear you say, you don't run from nothing, dog. Get your soul. Just tell him that the break is over. Like one with Nicki now. Tell a rapper, I'm gonna see ya, huh? I'm a pilot like Bieber, huh? I'm f***ed, I'm queer, huh? But then, I'm a deer, yeah. Hey, holy do it. I ain't fall off, I just ain't release my new s***. I blew up and everybody trying to sue me. You call me Nas, but the hood call me Doobie. And this one is for the champion. Ain't lost since I began.
I'm the meaning of what persistence is. And music is the only thing I really love since I was a kid, and it's the only thing I'm gonna love forever. I've been through the hard times and bad weathers, long days and long nights, trying to get my career together. But school was my first goal, bumped and broad. I was blessed with a talent that could get me real far in time. And trust me, I'm nice with mine, and I'm sick with an instrument. Listen to the drum line. And all I got is more fire to come. A lot of cats is nice, but I'm liver than them. And these ATL streets is what I'm trying to rise up from. By any means, just to get that cream. It was hard, but I did it. Graduated to the big screen. Now I'm on tour, and the kid got bigger dreams.
Nothing lava. Get the bag, then I wiggle like Wilder. All the little things stop, big things. My little chain costs more than your big chain. When me get it back. 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 Don't block your blessings. Don't block your blessings. Diamonds disco flashing, drip toe tagging, mint coat dragging, block boy trapping, hot boy in action, don't need caption, rocks dame dashing, neck break dancing, blue miss hookah, game super, she don't bust it open, call back to Uber. I'm a dog, I'm a beast, got it on, never least. Out, leave the freaks, my condolence to the streets, them tents, I'm a strip, can't last. Crying, throwing bricks out. Yeah, ones and hundreds talking drip game, popping in a wrist game. Rock, trap money, stop all the driving. My name ring bells, Kaze Zoo. Is them uptown boys copy cool? Uptown boys, nothing live. Get the bag, then I wiggle like wild. All the little things stop.
Big
我是今天的主持人，交给彭尊的彭尊。Hello，大家好，好久不见，我是你们今天的主持人，我的名字叫汉帝，Handy
Lee，大家给我个彭尊一个最大的尖叫声！耶，终于回来了，哇，彭尊，好久不见，我们终于回来了。哦，跟各位讲，我们两个不是没有，Thank
you，对不对？ 好，讲到thank you这个部分，当然还有一位灵魂人物，有些人以为他不见了，但是呢，他其实只是移动了一下位置。我们把目光呢放到我们的左后方的上面，我们的灵魂人物 DJ Sean。All right, DJ Sean having fun。 好的，我们呢，去年是一个非常热血的赛季，虽然我们在季后赛呢铩羽而归，但我们王者不会轻易的认输。这一季我们誓言要重回季后赛，一起打造属于我们的王城荣耀。
那在我们成军第一年呢，我们球队的灵魂人物士官长呢杨建敏，去年呢场均缴出了惊人的 21.2 分、 4.86 篮板、 3.21 助攻的高档表现，那也获得2021-22 Plus League 年度 MVP 的殊荣。那今天呢开幕战大家来到现场，有很多很多跟我们 MVP 相关的周边在进场可以看到，那也有我们的 MVP 的集气墙，你可以在留下你各种留言来为敏哥也为新北国王一起成为我们的力量。
没错，那我们今天的中场游戏也将会有我们 Amigo MVP 挑战，最后获得的获胜者呢会获得我们本季全新王城荣耀的主视觉毛巾一条，想要参加的朋友千万不要错过。那我们在入口处呢也有我们新北国王首节首位得分球员的预测，如果有兴趣参加的朋友呢到我们的入口处投下你神圣的预测。
那皇家大使呢也要这边给大家好消息，延续去年呢时尚机能 Lululemon 呢今年一样和我们新北国王合作，在本季的20场主场赛事，每场呢会随机抽选一名幸运的球迷，那在赛后呢一个月内呢会有8000元等值商品可以让你去兑换，所以呢所有的球迷朋友记得留下你们的票根，我们今天就会公布中奖名单。
没错，我们呢在第一年的赛季口号相信大家非常不陌生，就是我们的 Crown the City。 那我们为新北市的国王们呢戴上我们的皇冠，但今年非常高兴我们新北市政府可以延续去年的冠名，跟我们一起为这片土地努力。接下来呢我们非常感谢已经莅临到现场的两位长官，第一位呢就是我们新北市刘和兰刘副市长，大家掌声鼓励。
Yeah，
那还有我们的第二位长官就是我们新北市政府教育局长，我们的张明文张教育局长，
跟大家挥挥手。
当然呢我们这边要邀请到我们新北市刘和兰副市长上台为我们致辞，给大家勉励一下，让我们用最大的爆动声欢迎我们的新北市刘和兰刘副市长。
谢谢谢谢，先代表侯友宜市长谢谢大家，谢谢所有球迷进到我们新庄体育馆为我们国王队加油，掌声鼓励一下。
Yeah，
这个一定要来，因为国王队去年头一次跟我们新北市一起冠名我们新北市的球队，这里就是我们国王队的主场。那我们知道去年我们的成绩第一次参加成绩就非常好，所以我刚刚特别跟我们的执行长陈建州，我们国王队的执行长陈信生，这个陈执行长还有很多好朋友说，去年差一点点，因为有疫情，在总冠军赛之前我们就差那么一步，
是
今年一定要要回来，所以今天是我们主场的开幕战。我们不仅有我们的国王士官长，我们杨敬敏，我今天穿的也是6号，他是我们的偶像，所以今天待会一定有对他有，因为他当选的 MVP， 所以今天他不仅会表现得很好，而且会拿到很高的殊荣。那今年我们国王队除了杨建敏，我看了资料，我们的去年的助攻王林书伟也加盟我们国王队，我们防守建厂的林金榜大手林金榜也加入国王队，所以我们今年战力更加的提升。那也谢谢国王队跟我们 PLG 联盟，我想篮球运动在我们的这个年轻时代里面世代里面是非常喜欢的。那新北市的 HBL 也非常的强，我们前四强里面有3队就是新北市的球队，所以谢谢国王队不仅会办校园的巡回，也会到我们的这个各个地方去办公益的娱乐营，最重要的是可以到我们的学校跟我们这些教练还有 HBL 高中国中的学生聊一聊如何打篮球，我想这个都是在我们比赛过程看不到的他们在基层的努力。所以今天谢谢各位球迷进到现场，我们有个默契，今天主场冠军我们留下来好不好？
好，
立下，抱歉了，支援那个 你如果是桃园的球迷，这一场是主场，就在我们新北，所以这一场主场，我们就把这一场的胜利留下来，期待我们今到了明年季后赛拿下总冠军。谢谢大家。
非常感谢我们新北市刘安刘副市长，大家再给他一点掌声好吗？好的，在比赛开始之前，相信大家都非常期待我们呢。今天由我们全新新北国王啦啦队的全新阵容，让我们来欢迎我们新北国王啦啦队 Chris 所带的开场表演。All right, DJ Sound, you ready? DJ Sound, we drop the Queens!
Love it when I poke it out in that fake sleep. Hit it from the back, making beats like Takey.
Yeah, he love
it. I'ma shake it like dice. Wrapped around my finger, eating booty from the bite. Booty make a cry. Booty make a nigga swipe. Booty walk him in the store and tell him hurry up and buy.
Shake with your Dr. Gay up.
It's a lot of bitches wishing they could see me there.
Shake with your Dr. Gay up.
I'ma make him pay the second round of this PBL.
Who else got an ass like to? Who else throw it back like to? What else make him mad like to? What else make him act?
Yeah, I know he like my
booty, 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 booty.
Yeah, I know he like my
booty, 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 booty.
Yeah, I know he like my
booty, 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 licious. Booty make him cook, booty make him do the dishes. Booty, booty, make him wanna turn me to his missus. Booty, booty, make him wanna give me all his riches.
Booty, 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 booty.
Yeah, I know he like my
booty, 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 booty.
Yeah, I know he like my.
最大的尖叫声给我们新北国王啦啦队 Queens。 Alright, alright， 非常感谢我们新北国王啦啦队 Queens， 看到他们全新的阵容以及全新的服装，相信大家呢都感受到 Queens 的重磅回归。那接下来呢，在本季首场主场赛事开始之前，为了致敬我们的阿美族战士，并为我们新北国王本季赛事带来祝福，我们要先邀请吕北都兰部落文化艺术团所带来的开场战舞，大家尖叫声好吗？ 感谢我们吕北竹南部落文化艺术团为我们全场的球迷朋友以及在我们荧幕前面的朋友们带来最大的祈福，希望我们整个赛季呢都可以顺顺利利。感谢我们的吕北竹南部落文化艺术团。
全新赛季第一场，新北国王将面对桃园埔园领航员，双方球员早已准备就绪，火热比赛即将开打。首先介绍客队桃园埔园领航员，五号林之伟，六号关达佑，十五号陈冠权，二十二号黄宏汉，二十五号林正，三十号白耀成，六十九号卢俊祥，零号陈玉瑞。接下来介绍先发五人 starting five， 十三号 Sunny， 二十一号陈立焕，二十七号张振雅，二十八号施静瑶，四十号沃许本，总教练卡米诺斯，助理教练迪亚哥黄启峰。助理教练兼球员发展总监杨怡峰，数据分析师柯焕维，技术教练唐伟杰，体能教练刘年杰。所有现场的球迷朋友们，将你们目光一致，上方打一幕，拿起你们的排排扇，一起打节奏。世新大学禁卫军御膳大厨李卫廷，Number One 左右开弓，出什么力？林书伟， Number 10, 禁卫军弓箭手，微笑射手箭右准。Number 7, 观众拿来看，小丽林立人。Number 3, 来自国立体大，小米陈俊南。Number 19, 皇家大锁林金榜。Number 25, 来自政治大学 Omar 小 Q 聂欧马。Number 15, 继位之门神 Q 昆西。接下来介绍先发五人 ，Starting Five。Number Nine， 全能后场指挥官，十秒秒不玫瑰，李凯燕。Number 55， 后援部砍将。Kenny Medical 曼尼高 Number 30 最强居酒屋老板杨新志 Number 5 禁区猛兽熊大白人布伦Number 6, 禁卫军士官长，新北大美族战士杨杨杨杨敬斌 ，Let's go！ 总政 Rama 将助阵 Mark Capella， 许浩辰体能教练刘振宇，首席分析师张崇新，数据分析师林振宇。球队经理洪志虎，防护员邱国凯、吴崇豪，总经理毛嘉恩，执行长陈信生。那请双方球员呢至旁边稍待片刻一下。我们即将要进行我们 MVP 的颁奖仪式。那在比赛前呢，我们要进行一个非常非常重要的颁奖仪式，那就是 Plus League 2021-22 MVP Tosha 的颁奖。那台湾保时捷呢和 Plus League 呢都有开拓的精神以及逐梦不停下脚步的强悍信念。从开机来，我们看到每场精彩的比赛以及各式各样球员的梦想故事，期待 Dreamers On 能陪伴这些球员们的完成梦想，让我们一起携手。现在就让我们欢迎2021-22赛季 Tosha 新北国王禁卫军士官长背号六号杨。
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, seniors and youth. Week 2 of Plus League basketball is underway. As earlier, the Dreamers open up their season this afternoon in Taizong and have their first victory tonight. We bring you the contest between the new Taipei Kings and the visiting Taoyuan Huyuan Pilots. It's my pleasure to introduce Sophia Song, the first woman to wear the headset in Plus League commentator history.
Thank you so much, Ryan, and the Plus League for inviting me today. I'm a little nervous, but I'm just excited and happy to be here.
Well, you picked a really great time to have your debut. Amigo Yang Qiming was presented with his league MVP trophy, along with the executives as our great sponsors in Porsche. Well, there's our Mandarin broadcast duo. On the left is Chen Ziwei from Zhenzi University. On the right is Eddie Zhang Yaozong from FTV. 球迷朋友们，你找到了英文转播，要看中文的转播讲评的话，那当然按照我们官方的中文连接就好了。So the new Taipei Kings, the fourth place team last year, went into the playoffs, whereas the now Taoyuan Puyuan Pilots want to make it back there. They participated in the very first season's playoffs and were defeated by the Dreamers last year with a sixth place team in the league, but looking to make some big improvements this year. Sophia, how do you like the MVP t-shirts, though, that the Kings and the staff are wearing?
I love them. I pointed out to you earlier that they're very American style with the vintage and with, you know, the MVP Amigo on it. Really enjoyed the shirt.
新北国王的主场开幕周有什么特别的呢？好的，我们来欢迎毛总。嗨。
欢迎来到国王的城堡，对，新装城堡，对不对？是是是。那我们请毛总马上现在给我们介绍一下，今天来到这里，我们进场可以拿到什么样的？好，没问题。因为上一季的大家应该都不陌生，就是杨敬敏，他是去年的 P League 的MVP， 那我们今天刚好有一个颁奖典礼给他，后来就是大家有看的话，就是他喜欢戴的这个护腕，对。 也今天进来进场都可以收到一个，那从这边开始就是很多阿明的一些素材，那这就是接近一比一的一个比例，我们有让他做一个这个膜，对手膜，你可以看到他是有多大的手，这样子，我脚才14号也算很大了，那他脚比我还大，15号，所以，那一样这个是这周末有推出的，就是 阿明的 Bubblehead， 那这个我觉得你们看一下，超像的。为了他在 MVP 纪念他 MVP，
包含还有一个我们这个纪念框，对，很特别，然后去纪念他去年的这个表现，我们觉得非常不容易。毛总今天非常的详尽哦，帮我们解说今年国王在开幕周有什么非常重要的看点。那谢谢毛总，
谢谢。
那我们现在呢也赶快来欣赏精彩的球赛。
The MVP for the home team getting all kinds of treatment, including the cheer card, the life-size wingspan you can take photos with, the hands, the shoe size, bobblehead. Well, time for some basketball again. Sophia, there's the shooting chart for Amigo. And on the left, he was number one in scoring for domestic local. He knocked down the second most twos, 2.7 per game, and also took the most free throws from the locals' perspective. The corners are his hot shooting spot. What have you observed in Amigo's game?
Just the overall confidence in how he attacks every game. He is probably the most difficult guard in the league, I feel like. He can hit shots from anywhere. That corner three is super deadly. I can't wait to see him play tonight.
The corners is a little bit interesting because Amigo's also made key threes from the top.
His interview pregame. 很棒的一个赛季，对，那当然对我自己个人而言，那确实，我的努力，我的付出也得到回报跟肯定，对团队来说，因为人员上的变动，那其实我想对我还是对整个团队来说，其实也都是从零开始，然后我们其实在这阶段其实也做了很多的 磨合跟调整，对，然后，近况也非常的不错，对啊，然后我想就是，今天对我们来说是第一场球赛嘛，那我想我们也会把最好的表现还有近期所努力的一些成果，然后呈现在这个球场上。So
that's Amigo saying it's nice to have all the hard work rewarded and to get recognized by members of the voting media, and the second part is about how the team would go through ups and downs, and he personally wanted to improve his offensive arsenal, and with a fresh start, with a longer season, they hope to get more guys into their rotation. On the other side for the Pilots, Coach Yuri Caminos is the first ever foreign coach for the Hu Yun and now the Pilots organization. Last year was with another team here in Taiwan as the head coach, and the year before was in the B2 of the B League. He's got his staff dressed up in sharp all-black outfits. Completely new look. Sophia, have you ever been part of a program where the coaches would change
after this
interview by Yaya?
像我们第一季可能就是比较属于个人多啦，然后第二季可能要团队，可是有时候在团队也没有到融合的很好，然后到今年就是卡总就给我们的内容就是比较明确一点，像进攻上面还是防守上面，他也是有分工合作，可是他会讲的比较明确一点，因为毕竟他不会去要求你一定要怎么做，他会跟你讲说你要怎么去阅读进攻或防守。对。
So the first thing Ayo said, now the team captain of the Pilot there in white, saying it's really different to have a handsome Spaniard in the locker room. But after the first season where the team strategy was more individualistic, it's going to be a new look Pilots as we have our starting lineup from left to right, Ayo, Calvin.Rookie Zhang Zhenya next to Sonny and Jason Watford, who saw in the preseason. Now for the Kings, we have Kyle Lee Kaien, Kenny Manigo, Amigo, Yang Xingzi, and Myron Mullins, who you guys know from last season. Vice Mayor of New Taipei is in there for the ceremonial first tip. The Kings in yellow and the Pilots in white.
我们这边呢就请我们的刘和兰刘副市长为我们进行开球仪式，让我们一起倒数三秒 ，3, 2, 1。好的，大家掌声鼓励，谢谢我们的刘和兰刘副市长为我们进行我们的。
So we have about 5 seconds before tip, Sophia. Have you been ever part of a program where the head coaches would swap in your career?
Oh, no.
We'll talk about that later. The lower levels filling up as we see the crew chief for this group, Long Yun Han. There's the first tip, and Ayao, going to be running point more this season. We'll start off with the basketball. He was playing point in the first season as Zhang Zhenya takes the first shot and bricks it to the left.Interesting because his head coach from college is commentating on the game. Zhang Zhenya, a champion multiple times with Zhengzhi University. Amigo at the elbow, one of his favorite spots. Going up against Calvin, traded from the Dreamers. Step back is up and a short. And a little unlucky shoe on the sidelines out of bounds.The second chance for the Kings. I guess we should also ask you this. Have you ever been traded in your career?
No, I have not.
Okay, well.
I hope I don't.
Sophia Song, a player here in Taiwan, in her spare time, no, in her main job. There's another missed shot, and Sonny's got his first stats in the Plus League. He and Caminos played and coached together last season.Rotated around. Ayao's three is in. The first score of the game.
Nice shot by Shi Junyao. Looking to see him come into the game and hit a lot of threes for the Pilots.
Mullins with the braids. Catching Washburn, hand in the cookie jar.
If there's something about Mullins that I noticed in the preseason is how he's able to get the defenders to foul him.And get to the line.
Was a very productive player in the preseason. Averaging 23 points per game. Follows that missed layup up with a putback dunk. And so the Kings are now on the board. Rebounding has been an issue for the Pilots in their two seasons. Calvin down the middle gets the shot to go.
Nice little floater by Calvin. Really looking for him to step up on this team offensively and defensively.
He was a member of the All-Plus League first team with the Lioneers two seasons ago. Danny Manigo missing his first shot, but the tallest player on the court is Byron Mullins. He couldn't grab the rebound.
Interested in seeing how Kenny plays tonight, as we didn't get to see him in the preseason.
Kings choosing not to challenge that one, even though they can. Coach Ryan Marchand is back with the program for a second season. There's a miscommunications and a ball out of bounds. Well, Sonny did not play with the Pilots in the preseason. He had some national team duties with Palestine. He's a very got a storied career playing in international competition. Right now, matching up against number 13, Yang Xingzi. Amigo on the curl. Bounces it off of Sonny's foot.
He was looking for his teammate down low, but I felt like he should have just went up for that layup.
Kenny from the corner, off the mark. Byron Mullins strokes it from three.
You know, that is what Mullins does best when he's able to stretch out the floor, stretch out the defense, and knock down threes and twos. That's what we like to see for him for the Kings.
Sonny will try to answer it a little strong, and Washburn stepped out of bounds. Just a team rebound. One-time hit. Three three-pointers in a row in his debut. I believe that was against the Lioneers. Down to Yang Xingzi. Turns and knocks down
nice.
The hook shot. Yang Xingzi is a little bit more involved.
Great action by the Kings and looking for that open cutter down low.
The Washburn will try from three. Tapped out by Sonny. Right-handed runner is in.
That runner by Washburn is tough to guard.
Amigo from the low post. Get a piece of Calvin there. Well, the man who shoots the most free throws as a local last season is going to go to work. Started with good defense, but Calvin probably could have let up a little bit at the end. Last year, Amigo averaging 84% from the line. He also took the second most attempts overall behind Sim Bular. As a team, the Kings were the best free throw shooting team in the regular season at 72%. Now they have the lead at 9-7. High out with Lee Kai-en guarding. Got a 5 or 6 centimeter height difference on his counterpart for the King. Calvin from the elbow. That's a bad miss. Manigault through traffic and throws it away. We've kind of seen a couple instances where imports that are not so familiar with the program, not on the same page with their teammates, might take a little bit of time.
Definitely, just to build that chemistry. I'm interested in seeing how the post players on the Kings work together.
Jason Washburn with a one-handed stuff. Amigo pops and shoots it from three, no. Seven and a half minutes left in the first quarter, and the Pilots are trying to get in their first sub. It's second All Plus League teamer, Justin, number 69, Wu Jingxiang. He'll have to wait though as Ayao is tripped up heading toward the rim.
Looking to see him not only assist his teammates, but offensively look for his own shots as well.
There we see the replay of Migo hitting him across the chest. There's Justin checking in the game. One of the few award winners from the Pilots team, and kind of predictable when you're a last place team in only a six-team league. Off the down screen, Ayao clinks that one. No subs yet for the Kings. Going to Amigo down low again on Calvin. To the middle again, left short. But Kyle tracks down the rebound. With a mismatch and one for Byron Mullins. Not a good foul by Ayao there. He had Washburn behind him in support. For this and one free throw, we have a TV timeout, our first break in the action. It's the new Taipei Kings and the Taoyuan Fuyuan Pilots here in the Plus League. Quincy Davis is checked into the game. And the ball finally comes down to a former teammate of his, Pong Pong, wearing a different jersey this year. Well, Sophia, we forgot to introduce, what team do you play for, as we have a backcourt violation by the Pilots?
I play for Taoyuan for the WSBL, and this is going to be my second season playing in Taiwan.
You guys start a lot later in the year. I believe it's expected to have a January start for both the SBO and the WSBL, as we get our first look at Joseph Lin, now in new threads with a career Taipei Fubong Brave. Manigal stopped at the rim by Pong Pong. But Amigo jumps the pass. Corner three, no good. Justin from his favorite corner splashes that three.
Great job by the Pilots finding Justin in the corner for that open shot.
On the other side, though, a little bit of cherry picking by Quincy Davis there. It's going to be the third team foul, now fourth team foul by the Pilots. Well, this is what the Puyuan system really loves to do. Get out in transition and fill those lanes, get to the corner. Quincy Davis, in his second season as the Kings, as I mentioned before, was the pilot in their inaugural season. And just having him on the floor was all the difference for the Pilots, as they built enough wins in the first 16 games to make the playoffs. And then Davis went down with a hip injury. Calvin going back to Mullins, says no to that one. Helpful to have a seven-footer in for that. Washburn will try another three. That one's short. Manigault steaming up ahead. Big Euro step for the lay-in.
Nice attack by Manigault. Looking to see him get to the basket more and get his confidence going.
Kings are very aggressive on the perimeter, jumping a lot of these passes, leaving Pong Pong open for the three, and it's perfect. That's something that Caminos would like to see, a three-pointer advantage against the three-point happy shooting Kings. But the Flynn goes down, but recovers. But tip ball and Washburn with a three-on-nothing layup.
I can see the Pilots picking up their defensive energy. And these easy buckets in transition is what they're going to need if they want to win this game today.
There we see Washburn getting involved aggressively, but this foul by Calvin will send Amigo to the free throw line. Washburn didn't have the greatest of starts in the preseason, but recovered for the second game for a 20-10 performance. Talk about crossovers from Poirier into the Kings. Of course, Davis is the number one guy, but now they brought in Ling Jingbang, number 19. Another 37-year-old to be that wing stopper for the Kings. Made free throw by Amigo. He stays perfect out there as Sonny's going to check in the game for Washburn. The Pilots going a little smaller here. Well, third overall pick, Ethan Byelton, is running the show for the Pilots now. Bombo gets in a little trouble, gives it up. Good hands by Manigault. Got one man to beat, getting the foul at the rim. Bonglohan back to defense. Jiggly is a little bit too shocked to give Manigault some high fives back. What some teams like to do is like to have two big imports, but the Kings this year and last going with a small. Of course, the leading group in that category is Michael Singletary. Only 196 centimeters, you could say, but a perimeter import player. And a goal. Quick stint at Wichita State before starting his pro career. Majority of it spent overseas.
He's had a couple now, nice active possessions, just doing a great job getting to the basket and drawing the foul.
There's a foul on the outside, they call. Bing Jing Bang. I don't know if this name nickname would work so well, but sometimes they call him, well, Coach Metcalf will call him Bang Bang. which is confusing because they already have a pong-pong, where they used to have a pong-pong play together. There's Manigault once again, getting his hands onto the pass. Pilots already have 5 turnovers on the quarter. Sunny's driving on Davis with a wild floater. Mal Hunt collects the offensive board. Taking advantage of size there, quick foul. Pilot still not in the bonus yet. Definitely a tough one for Lin Jingbang. So as I mentioned, Pong Pong, interesting enough, changing numbers, going from 30 to 15, and then rookie Xiaobai will get the number. There's a foul there, but I'm pretty sure Coach Marchand's happy with the aggression that Lin Jingbang and the Kings are playing with on defense, as he has a word with Coach Caminos across the scorer's table.
I was going to say, it's getting physical out there. But it'll definitely stop attacks to the rim from the Pilots.
Well, Io said the second year under Coach Tony and Coach Johnny, they tried to play a team game, and they weren't on the same page as Sonny. One-on-one move for 2 points. In this third season, Coach Caminos kind of giving the team a little bit more free reign to figure things out. Double screen comes. Manigault close for space. Davis doubled underneath. Gets the shot off. It's a miss. And a second miss there. Down the floor, Migo played good defense. As we have a substitution for the Kings, it's Chen Junnan or Steve coming in for Amigo. You probably might have had a hard time finding this, but number 3, Steve, is called Xiaoming, whereas Amigo is not exactly called Daming, but that's where the nickname comes from. Trying to be a protege to the MVPs. Good guy to model your game after. As we have 3 minutes left in the first quarter. Go around Huang Hohan, but misses with a floater. Pilots got numbers. Sonny will settle for 3, but rims that one out.
Seeing quick possessions by both teams. I feel like they just need to stay patient and look for good shots.
That time, Davis with the turnover. Davis with the block, and Lin Jingbang, the primary defender, collects the rebound. There's Manigault. Went with a no-look pass there, but probably should have been a little bit more sure-handed with it. Another turnover for the Kings, as we see Davis there on the replay. Easy block shot there. The team that plays the most press man defense is the Dreamers, but the Kings, maybe true to what Amigo's saying, they're gonna rotate a few more guys in. Rotate more guys in and up that defensive intensity. Sonny splashes that 3.
That is what he does best, scores from outside and in.
Davis takes the bump. They don't give him the foul as the defense is legal, they say. A heat check for number 13, no. Down the right sideline, Joseph Lin. Down to Davis. Got in trouble finishing, but fresh in the game, Byron Mullins. Did not get a second attempt. Sonny shot 33% last season from three as Justin misses at the rim. Kyle down to Joseph. Good pass, but that's kind of the wrong target down there. On the cross matchup, finally fires short with it. Scramble for the rebound won by the Pilots as hopefully Byron Mullins is okay taking that incidental fall. Down the floor, Justin overshoots the floater. Sonny throws it at the rim. Kind of low shooting percentages to start the game. Playing three out there. 2-for-1 opportunity for the Pilots. Washburn from mid-range and another miss.
Both teams are struggling to score.
The Kings are on offense. They are only 5-for-20 from the field, getting 8 points at the free throw line. Meanwhile, the Pilots, 9-for-21, just a teeny bit better. Davis fakes off the defense. His mid-range shot is in to end the first quarter. So it's a one-point game after the first 12. You're watching a Plus League Basketball on YouTube.
Hello， 看一下大屏幕 ，Hello， 欢迎来到新庄体育馆。Let's go。来，跟着我们一起往天上比，像我们新北国王的 MVP 一样往天上比。Parker 教练也来到现场了。Hello， Parker，Coach Parker。 我们国王场边的球迷朋友们，大荧幕好不好？准备一下，来，我们一起往天上比，跟着我们的士官长一样，一起往天上比。 Hello， 一起指向天空。哎，应该是有看很明显。 Number one, Joe，Joseph 的球迷，来跟着我们的 Ken 一起往天上比，来随时关注一下我们的大荧幕，哎，比个耶也可以，往天上比，跟着我们 MVP 转，哎 ，Nice， 全场你做最标准。
This is the new Taipei Kings season opener. The Lioneers have their home opener next weekend. Tickets still available on the Ticksgraph portal. Search Gongtenzi or P.League with a plus symbol. Right in front of us is number 10, JJ Jinyota, making his season debut. He didn't play all of the first quarter. He made a trip out to Sophia, your neck of the woods, along with some other teammates for the Kings. Little U.S. outing.
I saw that they played in the Drew League, which I think is a really cool experience.
Well, one of those guys, number 9, Lee Kai-yin. Last season made the Plus League All-First Team.
He was very impressive to watch last season, and I can't wait to see what he does offensively in this game.
Had a hand injury that really hampered him down the stretch. Long line missing with that three, and the Kings are going to let him shoot that. Ethan kind of stuck on that screen as Kyle hit the tough runner.
Kyle with a great read off the screen and doing what he does best, which is finding those gaps in the defense and going for the two.
really close import to import handoff, and they're letting Washburn go one-on-one against Mullen. Partial block, and Huang Ohan will have to force it up nearby the rim. Right now, the Kings need to give a little bit more help to Byron Mullins with the rebounding. Spin move, and in. Sunny over Yang Xingzi.
Great matchup for Sunny.
And without Quincy Davis or Manigal on the floor, Yang Xingzi is going to have to mark Sunny more often than not on defense. Running low on time, Xiaoming gets to the rim. Left-handed layup is in. Still the only guy missing from that Southern California trip for the Kings right now is Su Sishen, who's got a wrist injury, but the other three showing off their stuff. Kings it with the board, but Kyle will slow it up. Mullins, Kashinsu, who can't finish. Justin came for the help. On the sidelines with JJ. Metcalf would say that's my favorite turnover, but it just happens so often. You would think that in the FIBA court, as Luka Doncic would always say, or Antetokounmpo would say, the space is bigger. Not there. I guess you would say the space in the NBA is bigger with illegal defense. Mayo and Calvin checking in for the game, so it's the starting set for the Pilots. He's got a post up against college opponent in Xiaoming. Off to the left with that right hook. Xiaoming from the corner hits the three.
Open in the corner.
That'll be the first team timeout called by the Pilots as the Kings kind of jumped out to this 7-point lead after some lackluster shooting by both teams in the first quarter. We'll go to another break. Thanks for watching Plus League Basketball.
不能领取我们限量的王成荣耀新主视觉的海报，而我们的毛巾。好的，得奖者是我们A1之3的杨君文，杨君文，恭喜你呢！ 获得了我们王成荣耀的新主视觉毛巾。好，现在呢，我们要丢我们中场游戏的球。The
Plus League is Season 3. We'll be publishing the last 2-minute referee reports. Keep an eye out on our social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter for those. It's Coach Marshawn in the huddle. We talked about Southern California before, but Marshawn, like me, is from Northern California, Sophia. Let's let that be known.
SoCal over NorCal.
So far in the game, the leading scorer for the Kings is Byron Mullins with 7. And Xiaoming Sanjunan catching up to starter Kyle with 5. Going with the baseline spin again, Sunny. This time to Washburn, who drains the 3 from top.
That's really difficult to guard when Washburn's at the 3.
Now the Pilots showing off a 2-3 zone. But they say it's off of Yang Xingzi. Good hands by
Zhang Zhenya, who goes by his Aboriginal name, Mayao. Here we see the reason why it's difficult is because the Kings might want to send help to defend Sunny. Quick pass, and he finishes through Yang Xingzi.
Sunny is making it look easy out here.
He's not the tallest of players, only listed on our website at 203 centimeters. He's about 6'8", but he sure is strong. Xiaoming from the corner rims in and out. They say foul on the strip as Yang Xingzi probably had his best defensive play against Sunny, if not for the whistle. You'll get to see it again.
Yeah, well, the strip.
So the fans are right to say, to maybe moan a little bit, as Kyle was the one who got the deflection, but that's a freedom of movement foul. Sunny from close to the logo buries it. Okay, well, that makes it even harder to guard.
Sunny is locked in. He's just getting started out here.
Now the Pilots with a one-point lead. And he goes to Byron Mullins close by, and he gets it on the reverse.
Nice find by Kenny Manigault to Mullins down low in the post. If they continue doing that high-low action, it'd be tough to guard.
This time screen for Sunny. Another heat check, and no problem.
Someone's got to put more pressure on him or something.
That makes it a two-point lead for the Pilots. Now the Kings want to talk it over on their bench. Well, the Pilots last season, only 7 wins and 22 losses. That was the last place finish for them. And if you look at the plus-minus stats, they are minus 241 in 29 games, which is the lowest in the league. The year before, in their first season, they were minus 104 in 24 games, which is the lowest mark. So they're really trying to turn over their competitiveness in this league. And, well, if an import's going to shoot like that, it's going to make it a lot easier.
Oh, yeah, that's for sure.
It's kind of a little different look because previously, general manager Sean Chen went with very athletic American scorers such as maybe Davon Reed, Kadeem Jack in the first season. Then it was, if I'm trying to remember correctly, Devin Robinson and Jordan Tolbert last year. But Sonny and Washburn, maybe their number one priority might not be in scoring, although right now I'm being disproven by number 13. But Washburn, real 7-foot center, and Sonny kind of do it all forward for them. Sometimes he even ran point for his team last season. That brings Sonny's point total on the afternoon to 15. He leads the field as the Pilots are second out of their timeout.
Looking to see how he uses his playing experience in Taiwan to his advantage.
Kings bringing in Joseph Lin and JJ, maybe trying to space the floor against the zone look by the Pilots, who are now switched to man. Manigault with speed beats everyone down the floor.
I expect to see a lot of that from Manigault. You know, I feel like that is just when he's at his best.
Washburn steps on the line as he's trying to drive against Mullins.
We got a nice little battle going on down there. Both sizable players, a lot of physicality.
And he go over to Joseph Linda Mullins in the left corner. In and out, but Davis Energetic looking there, gets the put back. Okamayo from the left wing overshoots it. And Rookie's got not an ideal start, but plenty of game left. Byron Mullins with an easy follow-up. Joseph Lynn played pretty good defense there on Calvin. Couple guys come over from Mullins as Quincy Davis getting the foul, but not the bucket. Good movement there by the Kings.
I'm honestly really surprised of Manigault's court vision. That was a great pass and fine to Quincy down low in the post.
Substitution. Amigos in for JJ and Justin and Guandayo in for the backcourt of the Pilots. Guandayo making his season debut in the second quarter. Was a rookie in the first year of the Plus League. A free throw by Davis and the Kings up by five. Have a 10-0 free throw lead in attempts against the Pilots. Interesting how the math works out. Though the foul count is 7-4, so it's not too lopsided. Five out offense for the Pilots as Joseph Lynn snuffed out the pass. Down to four, Amigo gets the easy lay-in. Sensing a little bit of danger, Camino's called timeout.
The Kings have been doing that very well, turning them over and taking advantage of it.
They've been doing a great job, especially intercepting some of those backdoor passes that the Pilots really love to run. Well, the Kings, on their side, they finished last season 16-14, which was four games out of first place. Even though they, even as a new team, had a piece of that first place spot, either alone or combined with sharing with a different team for seven of the 23 weeks we had last season. Now in the Plus League, in our playoffs, we still maintain the home and away as best we can, of course. That's been true for all but one game in our history. Well, the Kings, their biggest offseason acquisition was trading for number one Joseph Lynn from the Braves. He averaged 11.8 points per game, 3.9 assists there in the middle, trying to be a nice secondary along with Kyle Lee Cayenne to Amigo scoring. And Amigo was the only local player to lead any of the Plus League teams in scoring. But Joseph Lynn coming over, another point guard to play next to Lee Cayenne, whereas they traded away two wing players to the Braves in a move that certainly, we'll see how it works out. But James Mao indicating he'd like to rotate Joseph Lynn and Kyle for the longer season we have.
Definitely looking forward to see Joseph being more active offensively and knocking down shots at a high percentage, which I know he struggles at times.
Had a better three-point shooting in the first season, 33% as last year. That number went down to just under 30%. Now with a 8-point lead, Kings back down on a defense. Kind of a zone look of their own now. Quincy Davis in the middle as a sloppy pass. Manigault with another steal. Nice find as Davis able to finish at the rim. Now the turnover's becoming a problem for the Pilots. Now with eight, Sunny controlling with that three. Davis fouled on the way to the hoop by Sunny. And that was a foul by the Pilots import there after this play. But that's the kind of power that Davis would have. So hard to challenge at the rim, even for an import opponent.
I was going to say, he's doing a great job at getting to the rim, getting to the line, and running down in transition.
Last year, Quincy Davis, only a 65% free throw shooter, but got a good start to this season. Vinos extending on his rotation has number 00, Tony Ray, check in for Calvin.
See the Kings gear are pulling away a little bit from all the turnovers with the Pilots.
Washburn up top, they call traveling. Well, at least it was a dead ball turnover, but something that no coach would like to see is to see the steps taken there. With Justin on Amigo, Guandayo on Joseph Lynn. Now to Byron Mullen, who boxed out Washburn there.
Nice to see the Kings sharing the ball, finding each other down low in the post.
Justin fouled by Davis there. The body bump down low. It's only the first foul for Davis.
If it's one thing about Taiwan basketball that I notice, it's that backdoor cut. Not only for men's basketball, but for women's basketball as well. Just looking for that backdoor cut.
Well, now that you've been here for a year, Sophie, I can tell you that in Taiwan, they produce a lot more guards than they do wing players or forwards or, of course, bigs. So when you have so many guards in your rotation, everyone needs to put on a lot of pressure to deny, so that backdoor becomes open. Off on the curl. They say he bumps into Guandayo, who kind of took advantage of that double team there. Something you see very often. Well, a turnover for the Kings, leading the game by 13 points. They've kind of got the Pilots figured out in this second quarter, leading 28-14. Justin fouled from behind, finding a little bit of space on Kenny. I had a quick chat with him pregame, and it might be a little confusing if you've been watching the English broadcast of the Plus League, because Kenny says one nickname he could go by is KJ, or Kenny Jr., after his father's name. But the Kings last year had a KJ and Honkai Jie, their third overall pick from the draft. But now he was traded to the Braves, so maybe we could use it on him. We have a couple Jackie, we have a few Ryans. The name creativity is could use a little bit of work in this league. A couple makes for Justin there. Love running Kenny off of that left side pin down. A foul there by Justin. See it again. The main thing there is that Amigo was forced out of bounds, and that's why the referee called the foul. To the opposite corner. Kind of caught a little bit too open there. Sunny with the rebound.
Joseph having a slow start offensively.
Mandayo with a little bit of room. This is Malay up there. Is that something that players practice, shooting a layup while falling on the lower end of the fall? Everyone shoots the layup going up. Oh, it's beautiful, it's cool in the layup line. Maybe if you have the hops, you can dunk. But heading down like Guanayo there, your balance is thrown off.
Maybe we should start working on our off-balance layups.
I would highly recommend it. Two and a half minutes left in the first half. Out to Quincy Davis, keeping his foot outside the three-point line. And call for travel there as Justin. The man in front, they are saying all ball.
Look at the replay.
I think they got it right.
Yeah, I saw him take a couple steps there.
Justin stepping through. That time he got the lay-in.
Nice up and under by Justin.
Time out on the floor as the Kings might want to probably get a word in with the referees about a few of those possessions. Justin Lu Junxiang was one of the leading scorers for the Pilots in a team that sorely lacked offense without Devin Robinson or Jordan Tolbert on the floor. Now, we talked about the Kings making a trade. The Pilots also did with the Dreamers in the sending away point guard Hayden Wu Jiaqing and their longtime forward Manuel Lin Yao. So they, in return, got Calvin and a first-round pick, which at that time turned into the fourth overall in Amdi. So in a sense, the Pilots are trying to go with a youth movement there with a lot of young players, a lot of rookies selected in the draft. But in a small league like ours, where four out of the 16 make the playoffs, it's really anyone's game to sneak in and get a few extra home playoff games for, of course, basketball excitement, experience, and also, of course, some of that extra exposure for their sponsors. Out of the timeout, Kyle Lee Kai-in is in for the Kings. This time working on Justin down low. Back door as Sonny went down, but blown layup by Kyle. And another miss. For as good as he's played all the last season, he is prone to a couple of those close misses. Running low on time, Davis shoots the line drive out of bounds. A good defensive possession in the end for the Pilots.
I see the Pilots turning up their defensive energy and that pressure, hopefully to get more stops in this game.
Straight into the hands of Manigault. As Amigo trying to beat two there. Davis, one of the easiest putbacks, but common sight for all you Taiwan basketball fans out there watching for Davis for more than a decade play out here in Taiwan. Three-pointer on the handoff is good by Justin. Nigo from the right corner. They call a loose ball foul. They're trying to box out Davis there. Davis with a good start to his season. With 16 points. He leads all team scores. Foul there by Li Kaiyin. Trying to apply pressure on Guan Dayo. I don't think they had a foul to give. This would be a little bit too meta for me to go with a foul and a 2-for-1 now with 36 seconds left. But I think a lot of people heard what Chris Paul for the first time said, was it a 3-for-2? Have you ever heard about a 3-for-2, Sophia?
No.
Apparently that's with about a minute and like 5 seconds.
Oh, wow.
You want to get a shot up. Because now you were playing a 3-for-2. I don't know, sometimes 2-for-1 is already too hard to calculate.
Yeah.
Rounds out, and kind of curious, they call a jump ball here. That would be a first time for me. But two referees called it, so. At least they were looking at the same thing. Definitely a weird place to stop the game. You get another look behind the basket. Angle provided by FTB. Nothing there, nothing there. Oh, was it a wedgie? Oh, wow. Pretty quick with a wedgie call. We, the Pilots with the baseline out of bounds. Justin had that poked away by Manigault. He's been quite a menace for the Pilots' offense. Only credited one steal, but got almost a dozen deflections. This time the Pilots get the best of him. Washburn can't race ahead for the layup. It's going to be Pilot turnover for the Pilots. The referees say it was on the Washburn flick. They would be right. With 5 seconds left, the Kings bring on JJ. Over to Amigo. 1 second left. Can he get it off on time? He does. Right off the front rim. Well, that does it for the first half as the Kings head to the locker rooms with a 53-44 lead. But here in the Plus League, we're hoping to get a halftime interview. The player is going to be Kyle Li Kaiyin. As soon as we get set up with our TV partners there. Well, the Pilots, obviously within single digits, but you got a feeling that their offense is not finding their openings in the half-court sets.
I think Kings are doing a great job on defense, reading the Pilots' offense, but also capitalizing on the turnovers and being able to score off them.
There was Din Shan. Asked about what the Kings did well in the first half.
之前我們都還是一直不斷的在磨合，就是嘗試各種陣容，因為我們現在可能會就像我跟舒偉可能就會有位置重疊的問題，或者是我們會一起打一二號。那我們今天是都還在磨合當中，那今天也很久沒比賽了，第一場比賽我覺得打得非常非常的不錯，這樣子我們覺得還算可以，就是要自在他們的範圍裡面。對，
所以有信心可以帶走這場勝利嗎？必須說有啊。謝謝凱燕，下半場繼續加油。
We'll head to a halftime break and some halftime analysis after these messages. Welcome back inside Xingzhuang Gymnasium, home of the new Taipei Kings. It's Chen Ziwei and Zhang Yaozhong on the Mandarin broadcast. I'm Ryan Chen, joined for the first time in her broadcasting career, Sophia Song. Well, there we see the combined team statistics for the Kings out to their lead, though they're not necessarily shooting better from the floor, but as we've noted, they have taken advantage of a multitude of Pilots turnovers to score easy in transition and really stop the Pilots offense, especially for the Pilots. We saw a lot of their handoff game and they're trying to go backdoor like you mentioned, but what do you think it would be a great counter for defenses maybe underplaying some of those underneath defenses?
I definitely say maybe better reads off the handoff. So if you see that they're cheating more and they think that they're going to do the backdoor, like coming off instead for instead of the backdoor, fake the backdoor and then come around for the shot. Also feeding the ball to their scorers. I saw that Sunny didn't really get a lot of touches towards the end of that half there. And overall, just not turning the ball over, I think, will be super key for the Pilots. They want to close this gap.
One of the guys getting in the way of that is their new import, Kenny Manigault. But on the other side, the Kings have not had a great three-point shooting game up to this point. Last year, they're number one in attempts and number two in three-point percentage. You saw earlier, 3 for 15 from three. Should the Pilots consider maybe zoning up a little bit more?
I think a matchup zone might actually bring some problems to the Kings. Most of the scoring right now is around the paint, a lot of cuts to the paint, a lot of fouls to the paint. So being able to spread the offense a little bit out more, I think might stop the scoring for the Kings.
One more break before we're back. It's like you play basketball.
前往 Lululemon 任何一个门市进行产品体验，并带走价值8000元等值的价值商品。那我们现在要公开抽中我们 Lululemon 大奖的幸运儿，请注意你的座位号码。让我们恭喜这位是四位女生，是在我们 C 之舞8排之16的刘子瑜。 刘子瑜朋友在吗？刘子瑜同学，刘子瑜。好的，我再讲一次，是我们 C 之舞8排之16刘子瑜刘小姐。那麻烦呢，等一下记得到我们的商品部，好，记得到我们的商品部领取我们的这个兑换券。那我们这位刘子瑜同学呢，恭喜你哦！ 也可以获得我们这个 Lululemon 的大奖，可以带走我们价值8000元的等价值商品。
If you're watching our broadcast on YouTube, give our new color commentator Sophia a thumbs up for the stream. There's Zuwei and Eddie once again bring you the Mandarin commentary. After one half of basketball, the New Taipei Kings lead by 9 as. We have a chance to look at the leading scorers, starting with the Taoyuan Puyuan Pilots. Sunny with 15 points, followed by Justin's 11, Washburn's 9. Siqingyao, who started the game and is the captain with 3 points. Well, Sunny, we mentioned he could score from inside. He knocked down a few threes, but as you mentioned, didn't have that many touches to end the half, and actually didn't even pull the trigger. As we see, he's got plus-plus range out there. And on the other side for the new Taipei Kings, Quincy Davis leads the field with 16, Byron Mullins with 13. So it's pretty obvious to me, Sophia, that the size of the Kings is giving the Pilots a little bit of troubles in the interior. And of course, both guys can stroke it from three as well. That's always a threat.
Yeah, I definitely want to see the Pilots, you know, clog up the paint a little bit more. Maybe force the Kings to shoot more threes from the outside. And for the Kings, I think continuing that aggressiveness defensively and just being able to continue reading the Pilots on offense.
Both teams like to spread the wealth with different field goal opportunities, shot opportunities, of course, scoring out there. But right now, the Pilots, local players especially, are having some troubles getting the high percentage shots and executing on those. Of course, a lot of those easy turnovers will definitely put him a little bit in the hole. We'll go to one last break before starting the second half after this. Indoor dining is now available in Xingzhuang. Come on to experience yourself wining and dining while watching a Plus League of basketball. Each stadium has their own rules and regulations though, so you'll have to follow the team's guidance. So before we get the action started, Sophia, what was the original story from you moving to Taiwan, in fact?
Yeah, so about a year ago, I mean, this is probably even when I started playing basketball, 14 years ago, It's been my father and I's dream to come back to the land where both my grandparents are from and come play basketball here. And it's honestly been a dream come true. Just being able to be the first Taiwanese American to play in the Women's Pro League here, the WSBL, just super honored to be here.
We're glad to have you as we get all things checked off the list. And here comes the second half. For the Pilots, they have Justin Wu Qingxiang in for Mayo in their starting set. But for the Kings, it's their starting five from the first half to the second half. Migo with the elbow catch and shoot. Hit that one.
He is so good at coming off those screens and shooting the ball. Such a difficult guard.
It's really interesting too. He can shoot with either footwork too. Calvin though answers from the corner. Definitely want to improve on that second season he had with the Dreamers. Intercepted pass. Aya, one man to beat as wow. Manny calls. Skies high for the goaltending. Well, it won't count for the Kings the way they wanted to, but that's sure great highlight material.
Nice quick 5 points by the Pilots. They seem to be entering this half with a lot more energy.
Here's Manigal again moving left to right. That's the way he likes it. Kyle doubled there, as they say, off of Sijingyao's feet. They couldn't communicate the double team there in the corner. Washburn didn't get the pass, so Byron Mullins got a number advantage. Get to the rim, but overshoots it. Justin, given a lane, lays it in with the left hand. And right now, a 7-0 run. Well, 7-2 run, technically speaking, to start the second half, but 7 straight points for the team in white. Now Justin rejecting the screen, denying him the space as Kyle finds Yang Xi's down low. Left him open there.
Nice find by Kyle.
Now it's the Kings who are showing off a 2-3 zone. They don't have anything really interesting going as Justin forces one up. Pilots clearly not ready for a zone offense there. Amigo charges ahead but gives it up. Kenny with the mid-range. Man, he sure can fly on that follow-up you see there. Was an opponent of maybe Michael Singletary, the Dreamers, the Braves in the ABL, so fans paid attention to that competition, would have seen Manigal play. Missing from the corner. Forcing him left, Kenny spinning to the right. Good defense by Ayal. Calvin from the corner, his three, overshoots it. Mullins with one man to beat as Calvin got underneath. Right now, lid on both rims.
I find it hard commentating sometimes when both teams are struggling to score.
I hate to admit it, but yes, I have plenty of experience. Looks like we're, if I'm reading it correctly, they gave Calvin a warning for flopping underneath the basket there. Right to the hoop. Nice catch and a one-handed slam by Byron Mullen.
Nice set play executed by the Kings for the easy two.
Ayo missing at the hoop, and now a chance for the Kings to make it a double-digit lead. Mullins from three, got it.
Mullins can really knock down that three, and it makes it very hard to guard him.
Now he's the leading scorer for the Kings with 18. They call a foul first. It was Kyle reaching in there. Kind of giving the Pilots a little bit of a break there as they didn't have a good answer for the zone defense.
Nice, one more pass.
But they give up the opening. Finally, Ayo pulls the trigger and is off the mark. Not scored since the first quarter as he commits the foul on Amigo in transition. In fact, Ayo didn't even take a shot in the second quarter in 4 minutes of play. That makes it four fouls for number 28. That handoff, Justin swings it around Kyle, but Manigault once again there for the stop. Numbers for the Kings.
Oh.
Unintended pass to Amigo, who can't punish the defense. Justin will try in transition, no, and Sonny with a soft hand.
I think it'll be instrumental for both teams to just be a little more patient in transition.
Mullins will try another one and another hit. That makes it a 12-point lead for the Kings. They're making their season debut and their home debut. Justin will try again and off the back iron.
Zones are tricky. I feel like the Pilots are trying to see which shot can be the best shot.
Well, they've had a number of openings. They just haven't knocked down that three. Sonny, slow to get back, finally recovers. Jeans misses the bank shot. Pilots catch a break there. They're right now 1-for-6 on the quarter from beyond the arc. No substitutes for either team. Washburn able to get the bank up close.
Washburn's got a really nice hook shot. I think the Pilots need to incorporate him more on the offensive end.
Kyle springs free for the three, and now the Kings in danger, if you're the Pilots, of having this one pulled apart. Pilots call timeout as they need a breather and they need to refocus. Well, we'll head to our first break of the second half. It's Ryan and Sophia on the English broadcast.
Can't
Tomorrow is the rematch day of last year's Plus League playoff first round. The Braves are down in Taichung to play the Dreamers, and the Lioneers are here in Xinjiang to play the Kings, who started this third quarter off strong. Byron Mullins, a couple threes, and Kyle Lee Kayen got one of his own, while the Pilots have struggled, even though they've gotten open looks, only 1 for 8 in this quarter.
I would think the zone would be to their advantage with how they're shooting against the Kings in the preseason. But I think the Pilots need to be attacking the zone a little bit more, just to get that high-low going as well for the zone.
Already 21 points, 13 rebounds for Byron Mullins, and more trouble for the Pilots as Quincy Davis checks into the game. One of the best plus-minus players in the Plus League. There's another miss from the left side this time. Byron Mullins, and unstoppable.
Nice read by Joseph. If I were the Kings, I just keep beating Mullins. He's doing a great job of knocking down that three.
Zone kind of switched up with Davis in the middle now. Now a little bit more 2-1-2 feeling. Well, Pilots are still trying to break it with the pass. Now the dribble, Sonny to the other side, and you got the English.
I think that is what the Pilots need to kind of break down the zone of the Kings, just more high-low and finding the open player.
Sometimes you really need to take one good penetration to really rip apart the zone. Amigo trapped there. Joseph Lin recovers. And they say ball out of bounds. Interesting, now they're gonna bring in Pong Pong, so they got three bigs in there for the Pilots. We see Sonny showing off the skills. Great touch there. Justin on the baseline, able to get it. Pompon provides the screen assist.
He's been a little cold from the three, but he's providing the offensive energy that the Pilots need right now.
Actually, talking to some of my league colleagues, they say he's more of a slasher, as there's a high-low from Mullen to Davis. To Washburn, shot off. Up close, Washburn secure with it.
That's how you break down zones, just more cuts, more action in the paint.
Answering the zone look of their own. Mullins, this time, finally, I guess mercifully if you're a Pilots fan, with a close miss there. Justin will try his chances and just graze the front edge of the rim. Though with Davis's long arm, the referee's gonna talk it over. Chance for the Kings to sub in Xiaoming for Aming. Number 3, Centurion. So the crew chief giving an explanation to the Pilots there. Now at this point, because the ball goes out of bounds, it is something that they can challenge. And on that first look at the replay, Davis got a great chance at getting a tip on that shot. So for Davis, he will get a credit for the block, even though it'll turn into Pilots basketball. So really, Quincy Davis can't lose here. Right? The team has possession, and depending on the results of the review, you get a block to his name.
I think Quincy's been doing such a great job at doing all the little things defensively and offensively.
Last season, he only averaged 1.6 blocks per game, but when you calculate it out to per 36, that number goes up to 2.5. Now, Byron Mullins, in a smaller sample size, led the Kings last year at 3.3, but of course, joining in a little late, that story is he was teammates with DeAndre Liggins in England for a brief time. And when Chris McCullough went down with his ACL injury, DeAndre Liggins suggested Mullins' name to the Kings front office and got him over in time to be an important piece for them in the playoffs.
Wow. I think it's really cool how connected the overseas basketball world is. I hope we can see more dynamic players come to Taiwan and play.
The connection that Sophie is not admitting is she spent some time in England as well. You were a student at the same time you were playing, right?
Yes. I'm quite familiar with the men's pro league and the women's. Totally different game from Taiwan, I'll tell you that.
Well, the referees determined there was not enough to overturn it. So in essence, they just, the Pilots cost Quincy Davis a block shot. No, that's not what they wanted. Handing off to Joseph Lin. Little two-man game there as he drains the three. Well, so much for the cold three-point shooting by the Kings in the first half. They built themselves a 15-point lead here. Justin Washburn up close, shooting at a high percentage in the paint. Now 6 for 8 on the game from two. Manigault swings it over to Joe Lin. Byron Mullins gets his first touch in the corner. His three is up and knocks it down.
This guy is on fire. I think the Kings are just doing such a great job breaking down the Pilot zone. When you got the five knocking down threes almost every possession. I feel like that definitely brings some feelings of determined to the Pilots.
He is 3 for 4 on the quarter. That's already 11 points. For his personal game tally, that's 27 points. No Pilots are even in the 20s. So a foul in transition by Justin, and the right call. Taiwanese players try to get those fouls in transition, but hopefully with better education of the referees, they call those correctly, as you need to let the offensive player make a move there. Joseph, the natural lefty, gets it to Manigault for another three, rattles it home.
Joseph is doing a great job facilitating and finding his open teammates on the three.
Sonny will try to answer. He'll bounce off the top and the backside of the backboard.
Pilots haven't been able to really get him going in the second half yet.
Seven for nine, the new Taipei Kings are beyond the arc, and that's all you really need to know. Now Manigault from close. And at this point, if you're Coach Caminos, you're kind of wondering what needs more emphasis, the offense or the defense. Obviously, the answer is both. As Washburn, though, scores from close.
I mean, the Kings are just scoring at ease right now.
They got a mismatch, and they go away from it. Manigault will try another three, no problem. Call somebody at the league to ask for the single quarter three-point shooting record. Bandayo pulled from the bench. No good with a putback. That ends the third quarter. 87-65, the New Taipei Kings.
Super impressive shooting by the Kings.
Weather's clear outside, but it's raining inside the building as we head to the final frame.
I'm all MVP the captain.
好的，大家呢，帮我们把目光移到我们的大荧幕上面，我们呢跟着我们的 MVP Abigail 一起把手指往上。All right, let's go, let's go, Abigail， 没错，但是表现得非常好。Hello， 美女，帮我们把一起把手往上举。 That's right。 大家一起对我们的 MVP 杨敬敏给他一个最大的尊敬，给他一个最大的salute。All right， 没错，就是你，不用怀疑，一起把手指往上。Hello， 没错，就是你，一起把手指往上。Let's run。Hello， 看你们两个已经等很久了。 OK，Hello， okay. 小朋友，没错，一起把你的手指往上举。Hello， 两位朋友，跟我们杨敬敏一样，一起下流，一起往街上举招牌动作，给他拿出来。你的左手戴的护腕非常好看哦。Hello， 两位朋友。Hello， 这些情侣们，我们一起把手往上举，没错。
Some of the faces in the crowd here at the home of the New Taipei Kings, where Amigo is the imitation man. Number 55, the newest face to the Kings, Kenny Manigault. Now has 17 points on the game. Part of that 34-point third quarter. I feel like the pilot spacing on offense is not quite right against the zone. Justin missing from three as Manigault caught with a push there.
I think their offense against the zone right now is a little stagnant. They need to be more aggressive and attack the zone more.
Got plenty of fans nearby calling for the flop by Sonny, but the reality is When you're about to jump, you can be thrown off quite a bit, as you see with the rebounding foul there.
Yeah, especially if you're going up for that rebound and you got a defender pushing up you in the air.
Oh, off his shin though. Maybe not the best time to have some smiles, but Pong Pong and Sunny have one. Seems like we have a cross matchup going on. Kings are small with only Quincy Davis, the lone big, but the pilots with Sonny and Pong Pong. Manigault with hand all up in his face is almost hits it anyways. Looking to the corner, Justin to the other side almost. And a rebounding foul by Ling Jingfang. Bong Bong, believe it or not, only played one game last season. That was their finale against the Dreamers. He was able to score, unlike Susan, who's the other pilot who was making his season debut. Not dressed for today's game. Got some enthusiastic fans behind the Kings side of the basket, and the Pilots only 4 for 7 from the line. Not that many attempts, and obviously not converting on all their opportunities.
They definitely could be doing a better job at getting to the line.
In the fourth quarter in the Plus League, only one import allowed. It was Quincy Davis versus Sonny. Oh, excuse me, not Quincy Davis. It's Manigault. He's the one that has got the IMP next to his name. Ball out of bounds. They say off of Ling Jingbang. Looks like Deng Jun is going to get the warning for flopping on the other side.
Is that a common call, the flopping?
They don't usually, they very rarely tee up players. They definitely issue that warning pretty frequently. Now, the delay of game for tipping or touching a made shot, that has resulted in direct technical fouls before. Good effort by Huang Ohan, but he can't save that one in bounds. Mahoan sustained a knee injury last season while the team was playing at Guoti Da for that weekend. Left the space with the right hand, but Joseph Lin leaves it short. Do you ever wish that you were ambidextrous?
I'm a right-hand shooter, but I actually think my left-hand layups are better than my right.
Do you think we have enough film to put that to the test? Justin scores, and there's a timeout on the floor and a chance for the new Taipei Queens to perform center court. We'll go to break back after this. So some might say the new Taipei Kings need center from UCLA Thomas Welsh. Well, he departed for the Baslab Yamagata Wyverns in the Japanese B2, but so far through three quarters and a little bit, they look just all right now. Sneaking a look at Kenny Manigault and his green Nikes. Making his Plus Late debut to strong applause from the home fans.
Quite a dynamic player, just being able to see him attack the rim, find his teammates, knock down shots. It's what the Kings need from him.
To the corner, but batted out of bounds. And it kind of really makes positional sense because he's not exactly a ball-handling point. Of course, the Kings have Joseph, they have Kyle, and they have a few youngsters in the pipeline as well to try to play that point guard position. Mohan forces Manigault to the sideline.
I think that's what also makes him tough, just his vision for his teammates. Most of these import players want to come in and score, 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 but he's looking for his open teammates.
With an open three on the left side, off the mark, and Washburn can't get the rebound from Q. JJ, left corner, got it.
Another dagger by the Kings. I think that's JJ's first three of the game, actually.
That's actually his first shot attempt. Poked away, and Washburn, look what I found there. He can prove that scoring in the middle of the zone sometimes is the best recipe, especially because the Kings don't collapse on him.
Right.
To kind of leave the middle guy on his own as KJ Manigault scores through contact there at the rim.
He makes it look easy out here.
We've seen wild comebacks, but the Pilots better get started now. Fong O'Han puts that one through.
Possession by possession, if they can just get threes, get stopped, we might be able to see a comeback.
All they could do is foul there. It's only their first foul of the quarter. Time with Ling Jingfang, the screener. And then Pong Pong with a body bump. Finally set up the inbounds. The Jingfang in the corner. No, but Quincy Davis with the easy board. JJ on the reload as the Pilots. Besides Jason Washburn, everybody else has got to chip in on the rebounding side of things. Rolling it in, Ayal from mid-range. If three-point shooting is the thing to look for, leading the team last season was Lu Junxiang at 35.5% from beyond the arc. An illegal screen called by Davis.
I think Quincy had his arm.
They had the best
good.
Of
both players were kind of holding on to each other there.
They double it. The Pilots are lucky to retain possession. As Justin missing once again. So close, but the Pilots probably need to think about coming two extra days before their next Xinjiang game to get familiar with the sights and the rims out here.
Another great look.
The referees are talking it over. And they're going to elect to go to the video monitor as I believe both teams have unsuccessfully challenged in the game, so they can't ask for any challenge on their own. It's up to the referees.
How do the challenges work, Coach?
So, in the first two seasons, okay, let's see, no, this is a history lesson. In the first season, the coaches had one challenge, and if they're unsuccessful, they are charged a timeout. Full timeout or 30-second timeout, whichever one they have left. In the second season, you can challenge. If you're successful, you get a second challenge. But if either challenge is unsuccessful, a timeout is charged.
Got it.
In the third season, you can challenge the first time. And if you're successful, you can challenge a second time. But no matter if you're successful, or no matter the failure, first or second time, no timeouts are charged.
Wow, okay.
That's all in the bylaws you can download at the Plus League website. Well, they say it's gonna be Pilot's ball. Well, everything will help. Justin, swatted away by Davis.
I was just gonna say Justin needs to be attacking the rim a bit more and slashing, but it's tough going up against Quincy Davis.
Well, the closest Pilot was Hwang Hwan, and he's not exactly a rim finisher. Out of bounds, and they say it's for the Kings. Two teammates were reminded from Tianjin Technical University, Hwang Hwan and JJ. JJ was actually an MVP. They call a foul there. I don't know if it was on the rebound or on the shot. Well, for a long time, everyone thought that was the most incredible record to get MVP of a high school competition and MVP of a collegiate competition like JJ did.
Wow.
But then Jerry Tunyonwe of the Steelers broke all of that by winning three Rookie of the Years at three different levels.
Wow.
The Steelers this season starting 0-2 with two hardy battles against two tough teams in the Braves and Dreamers. Kyle got that one to come down.
What I noticed about Kyle is he definitely chooses when to take his shots. I feel like he doesn't always shoot the open shot, but he'll make that difficult shot.
Justin off the top of the backboard as Washburn can't get this one to go. There he tracks down the rebound. He's been close to a triple-double a few times. I believe he has one to his name as a player in the Plus League. Manigault trapped by the double. Flings it out, but right to the hands of Calvin. A little 4-on-2 there as Calvin muscles through for two, and the Kings get a timeout. Probably get some substitutes in. Get his guys a breather. 94-78 is the score. As Byron Mullen still comfortably the leader in individual scoring here. We see Washburn and Justin do a decent job with the double team. That's where Calvin likes to live, is in transition, where he's strong enough to finish through contact. He's got 7 points in 21, almost 22 minutes of play. Got to listen in to the Pilot's timeout as conducted by Yuri Kominos. Now, Hwang Hwan's listed at 192 centimeters. That makes him 11 centimeters shorter than Davis, but they don't mind that matchup. But Davis is out for now, and now plans are thrown off by the substitution. An honor to have Coach Camino, Coach Sean Kilmart, Coach Marchand as part of the preseason broadcast for a little bit. Foul from behind by Ayal. Yeah. on the double handoff, and Calvin in the right place for that rebound or turnover, whichever one. Little inside out as Justin flings it on the rim. No good. This is where I feel like the pull-up jump shot would be really helpful, but it seems like modern players aren't very adept at it.
I think especially for the Plus League, when you got big centers, big guys down in the paint, I think the coaches and trainers are teaching the guards to slow and quick runners.
Calvin through the middle, able to score with the left hand.
Calvin's been doing quite a great job at attacking the rim and getting the easy two.
All the Pilots pull it a little closer, now down by 14. Amigo from the corner, how could you leave him open? But he misses, and now JJ fouls in transition.
Pilots are getting lucky with Amigo's misses from the corners.
Maybe not the smartest take foul there, as now they have four team fouls. If Calvin is one of the best at in this league, is taking one of those off-footed, off-handed layups. That is definitely not something I expect pro ball players to work on.
I think his game in general is a little bit awkward, but it's really nice to see him step up offensively today.
Mayo left with space in the corner. After that miss, he's only 3 for 9 on the evening. Down low, Quincy Davis.
I think Pilots are trying to step up their defense, put more pressure and trap, but that definitely leaves open players like Quincy down low.
Washburn drains the long two there. Yeah, the guy they doubled was Byron Mullen, the tallest king, so easy find, an easy pass to Davis. He's got another opportunity, but Justin sniffs it out. Momentum to the basket as Washburn gets the alley.
If they can continue finding Washburn and capitalizing on the turnovers, they might be able to chip a little bit more at this lead.
A little bit more than 3.5 to go in this one. Joseph and Kyle in for some combined minutes. Deflected pass, Ayal, the one to bring it up. Going to the rim, Calvin from up close, another two, and timeout, New Taipei Kings.
Pilots are doing a great job scoring in transition.
That was a struggle for them. They were settling for three-pointers earlier in the game, but now when different guys are going to the basket, that really creates even better opportunities, no matter inside or outside.
I think attacking in general in man and zone will always open up players for the three.
And right now, Jason Washburn's proving to be one of the catalysts for their offense, a guy that's really hard to stop, especially on the run. He's a little bit lighter foot, a little bit more agile than Byron Mullins and Quincy Davis so far in the game. Interesting enough, right now you see on screen, the Pilots have two timeouts left in the game. Meanwhile, the Kings, no full timeouts left. They're only left with their 30-second player timeout. So they can't call that until under 2 minutes. So not a category that coaches want to win at, but right now Coach Caminos is winning at hanging on to his timeouts for now. 21-9, the score in the fourth quarter.
I think it's really interesting to see two coaches speak English to their teams, just because I'm surrounded by Chinese and Chinese for my coaches. But I think it's pretty amazing just the basketball and the many different languages that comes with it. And at the end of the day, just being able to all play the game.
One thing that the Kings have gone away from a little bit, or the Pilots have been better at defending, is the double screen up top. That's the first play set up. Davis, now Mullins. But it's Amigo. Not great spacing. Under 10 seconds, Calvin commits the foul. Off ball against Amigo. It's only their fourth team foul, so they did have that one to give. Be a sideline out of bounds. 14 seconds on the shot clock.
Are we going to see another high double ball screen?
Joseph Wynn able to lay it in on the back door. What's even more encouraging if you're a Kings fan is Amigo averaged 21 points last season. He only has 8 in this contest. As Justin able to drain the 3, letting out a yell in relief. Trying to apply pressure on Kyle in the corner as Amigo tries to find Davis and wow. Sticks with it. The Kings cross the century mark scoring-wise. Calvin takes the corner 3 and airballs it. That's a momentum killer. Washburn hedges. As Joseph Lynn, kind of lucky.
Was that a pass?
Was that a pass or was that a shot?
It low-key looked like he was directing that at Quincy, but I'm not quite sure.
Well, that forces the Pilots to call timeout in desperation. Now down by 13 with 105 seconds left. We'll see how the score is. Shot that one down. In any case, that brings Quincy Davis' point total to 24. Still a few points behind Byron Mullins if you're looking for the lead in scoring. Meanwhile, for the Pilots, Sonny's got 20, Washburn's got 23, Justin's maybe in a little bit more of a struggle, has got his point total to 20 as well. Both teams breaking their huddles. The Pilots, one full timeout, one 30-second timeout left in their inventory. Calvin, Ayao, Pong Pong, Justin, and Washburn. Kyle, Joseph, Mullins, Davis, and Amigo. This is probably their best 5 if you're the Kings. Washburn from the corner, showing off the range. Byron Mullins, 2-13. Couldn't get the stop. Kings playing keep away at lucky bounce. They hang on to it. the corner, Migo is still struggling from the outside as Calvin flings it up to the rim. Kind of dangerous play there.
I think he was trying to draw the foul, but lost balance there.
We're lucky that everybody is upright and okay. Well, the Pilots will hang on to possession. They're down by 11. Backdoor to Justin, but the Kings get a hand on it. Running low on time, Calvin swatted away by Byron Mullins. And they're going to call a shot clock violation. Well, he's been a real difference maker down low in a third of the season, now heading into the start to this one. Joe with the rock. Byron Mullins around over the shoulder. They end up fouling in the corner. Su Jingyao against Li Kaiyin.
From this angle, that pass looked insane.
So it was off target, so enough time for the Pilots to get a foul on. Su Jingyao is going to get subbed out of the game. I believe he's the first Plus League player this third season to foul out. Meanwhile, showing off a new haircut. He's number 4, Li Weiting, the rookie for them. He's going to come in with Omar and Xiaoli, number 7. That seems to be about it for this contest, as Kyle will shoot his free throws, and we got maybe another possession left. Looks like the regulars for the Pilots are going to get their treatment a few moments earlier before the end of the game. Were there any positive takeaways if you're on the Pilots bench from this game?
I would definitely say they did a great job at being able to score in transition. I think if they slashed a bit more and got those easy points in the high lows, that can be super deadly. I just think they didn't really capitalize on attacking the zone as much as they could have.
Calvin makes a better adjustment with a missed shot, and the Kings looks like will dribble out the clock. And that's it. They start the season at 1-0. The Pilots make a pretty decent showing out of it after being down as much as 22 points there in the middle of the game. Meanwhile, for the Kings, starting their campaign off strong after having mostly uneventful offseason sans their trade for Joseph Lin and their 2 draft picks.
Excited to kind of see if the Pilots can turn around from last season. And the Kings, honestly, they did such a great job today shooting. I feel like, I don't know if they can shoot better than they did today, but it was really fun to watch. And I'm excited to see how both teams continue to grow their chemistry and get better, honestly, this season.
That's true. We mentioned before, Washburn, his first time here in Taiwan. Sunny might be familiar with playing in Taiwan. He did play in the SBL previously, but the first time with the Pilots. And on the Kings side, Kenny Manigault showing off plenty of skills and ability. Of course, looks to be a great fit alongside either Kyle or Joseph Lin.
Right.
Well, the Kings on the game end up shooting 40% from the field and 16 of 18 from the free throw line, really keeping the game out of reach for most of the second half. Now for our
sideline report. 保持好该有的礼貌，我们呢就是在那边排队，良好的排队，不要插队，我们每个人呢都可以有机会签到名。大家请注意你的周遭，垃圾呢有没有记得要带走。
Well, excuse us. We'll be back after a break. Thanks for watching Plus League Basketball.
I think it really started off with the energy from the crowd tonight. It was a lot of energy tonight, and we really fed off of that.
那莫兰莎先感谢说，现场的球迷今天都很努力为大家为我们那个加油打气，现场声音欢呼声非常多，非常好啊。
And this is a team that had a lot of confidence against us. We scrimmaged them twice before tonight, and they beat us pretty good two times in a row.
领航员在之前我们在友谊赛跟热身赛的时候，他都击败我们，然后对我们都打得非常非常好。
So we just wanted to come out and make a statement. Our goal was to keep them under 93 points for the game, and we kept them at 91.
所以我们这样在进入到这场比赛的时候，我们的目标就希望把领航员得分降到93分以下。那我们让他们降到91分，我们成功达到我们的目标了。
And we didn't want to ruin Amigo's night. We had to get a win for him, most importantly.
今天是敏哥主题日，所以我们大家都支持他，支持敏哥。
那我们知道，穆伦斯他今年回到新北国王有一个非常大的改变，就是他瘦身了，对不对？可以请他跟我们谈谈，他是怎么样在短时间内瘦了这么多？那这对他在球场上的表现又有什么样的影响呢
？Yeah, as soon as I left here last year, I knew I had to come back in better shape. You know, me, Phil, and James, we sat down and had a goal, and it was to be 270 pounds for today's game.
在这场比赛之前，那个莫伦斯跟那个我们的关键神就有个讨论，就是要在目标要降到270磅啊，然后这场比赛迎战这场比赛之前。
And I came back at 313 pounds, and then today I'm actually 270. So.
啊，一开始的时候是313磅啊，现在是270磅啊，哦，所以这瘦非常多。
Yeah, the way it affects the game, I can run up and down the floor a lot faster than I could, you know, when I was here last season. And I can play a lot more minutes with the weight gone and me being better conditioning. So I pride myself in working and getting extra reps in and hitting the extra gym time. So I think you guys see it paid off tonight.
减那个减重，当然让他可以在场上跑得更快，然后也让他可以在场上待的时间就更久，因为他也更有力。那所有的一切的减重呢，在今天的表现也可以展现出来这阵子减重的成果。好的，谢谢穆伦斯，也恭喜他今天有很棒的表现，当然也恭喜新北国王今天拿下胜利。最后是不是请穆伦斯对现场新庄城堡的球迷，还有电视机，还有收看网络的球迷们说几句话？
Fans, everybody, thank you for bringing the energy tonight. We're going to need it tomorrow. We got obviously a back-to-back against the finals runner-up, and it's going to be a good game for us tomorrow, but we need everybody in the seat and bring a lot of energy and be loud for us.
莫伦斯，谢谢大家今天到场。那明天我们要对上工程师啊，去年的第二名的球队，希望明天大家也可以一样的到场支持我们啊，谢谢大家。
谢谢穆伦斯接受我们访问。那现在呢，我们就把时间跟镜头交还给主播还有球评。Well,
thanks for Byron Mullins for sticking around through a little bit of the technical difficulties and answering a lot of questions. And I think I could maybe suggest he might have a bonus with a particular weight clause. Does 270 seem like to be the big number for him? Well, it's good to see him back. He's obviously a really great player on the floor, but also a fun guy that the fans really respond to. And we'll have another tough game for the Kings against the Lioneers as they battled to 5 last year in the playoffs. There's the final combined team statistics where the Pilots, 29%, it's a little bit below their career average as a team, but they needed a few more to really get into it against the Kings, who in the end out-rebounded them and were able to get through the game, even turning the ball over a few more times than the Pilots. Was there any standout performer to you, Sophia, in this game?
I was just really impressed with Mullins tonight, just how he was able to attack the zone and hit shots. Like, it's kind of crazy to see how this game turned out with Amigo not having his average scoring game, but we're super excited to see how tomorrow plays out against the Lioneers.
Speaking of tomorrow, it's the Taipei Fuyong Braves down in Taizong against the Dreamers, and as you heard here, the Hsinchu Jiekou Lioneers against the Kings in the 5 p.m. game. We hope to have you on for another broadcast of Plus League Basketball. Sophia, good job for your debut, but you got another one. That's the key. The back-to-back really catches some people off guard.
Thank you for having me, Ryan.
All right. Yeah.
We're here.